Mr. Shetney the left flank. Let's give them a welcome, according to the military etiquette.
Thank you.
howitzers give us a lot of trouble. The sooner we neutralize them, the better.
Verstanden!
Seems we gave some hell today. The enemy suffered much heavier casualties, and that was undoubtedly a success. But let's get down to business. We have just received a radiogram from Rommel, ordering us to leave our positions and advance to join the rest of the Afrika Corps. So, pack up your things. We're retreating to the valley. Thank you. My friend, we are in big trouble. The New Zealanders attacked Rommel's division on the march. There's no time to establish defenses, so he will maneuver and try to join us there.
Damn! This means we shall have to dig in the open and fight the Tommies until his tanks arrive.
Commander, British vehicles are closing in from the east. Turn the guns.
Verstanden.
Sam! We made it! We had out!
Often enough that Rommel's methods differ from traditional warfare. However, I see no alternative in given conditions. In a vast desert, there's no role for paratroopers. It's up to tanks and artillery to save the day. Being a personal adjutant, the 11th Division commander of the Africa Corps, I saw firsthand that he was right. No doubt the Battle of Sidi Rezegh would take its place in the military history, and I'm grateful to General Kruger for giving me the chance to be part of it. We are always on the march, and when brute force is not enough, we use guile and maneuvers. It seems that Tommies have never learned to fight on them, and sooner or later, we shall rid every of them. Cunningham's venture ended with black smoke rising into the sky above the remains of his army. And news from the East Front also gives cause for optimism. Our troops have already approached the outskirts of Moscow, and soon all of Russia will bow before the supremacy of the German nation.
The November battles had neither winners nor losers, with both sides receiving heavy casualties. But while the British managed to re-equip themselves relatively quickly, the Africa Corps supplies left much to be desired. The Germans were forced to lift the siege and retreat to Tripoli, and the situation in North Africa became stable. During this time, Borg was doing paperwork and errands at Ludwig Cruvel's headquarters. However, peace would not last long, and during a routine flight, Cruvel's Storch was forced down by the British and he was taken prisoner. Meanwhile, Army Group Africa launched an offensive, with the Germans inflicting heavy casualties on the British and securing critical supply lines, forcing the Allies to pull the bulk of combat-ready troops to the Egyptian border and leave Tobruk guarded by only a small garrison. This played into the hands of Rommel. Having finally decided to launch another assault, he scheduled it for the morning of the 20th of June. The success largely depended on the surprise factor and the interaction of the Africa Corps divisions.